iOS 26 is finally here, and while Apple added a ton of great features, there are only a few that really deserve your attention on the first day. Now, these are my list of top 5 practical features that you can set up right away during the course of this video so you can get the most out of your iPhone immediately. Let's get started. First, give your iPhone a brand new front door with the redesigned lock and home screen. This is where you'll notice iOS 26 every single day because you pick up your iPhone 40, 50 times a day easily. Apple redesigned it so it's not just prettier, it is more personal, and it's more useful. Now here's how you can try it. To edit your lock screen first, press and hold on the lock screen for a few seconds, and then tap customize. Now you'll see these rectangles or these bounding boxes around the areas that you can actually edit. There's one around the time, there's one around the widgets, and there's one for the wallpaper. You can tap the time box to change the font and style, including this ultra cool translucent clock, which can auto adjust depending on the wallpaper that you have. You can tap on the widget box, and the widget box can actually be lower towards on the bottom of the phone itself, or it could be up or near the clock, and add or swap in new dynamic widgets, or even change the lock screen controls in the bottom left and the bottom right-hand side of your lock screen. And there's a wallpaper toggle where you can choose to add a spatial 3D wallpaper that shifts and moves around as your phone changes orientation in your hand. It's actually very cool. Depending on what your wallpaper is, it works with people, it works with pets, it works with cities, landscape scenes as well. And it does add a nice 3D effect that I think that you'll enjoy. Then you can update your widgets. You can tap in the widget area, swap in the new dynamic widgets. You can see things like live weather, calendar, or even your, say, your move rings without necessarily opening your phone up. Now here, spending 2 minutes will make your iPhone already feel completely refreshed, unlike any other iPhone before it. All throughout iOS 26 is Apple's brand new liquid glass design. It is light, it is whimsical, and it is minimal. And here's how you can push that design onto your home screen. First, tap and hold on the home screen. Then click Edit. Under Customization, you're gonna see some icon styles, including two new styles. You have Default, you have Dark, you have Clear Light, Clear Dark, and there's a brand new tinted option that's been updated. If you tap Clear, your icons instantly get a glossy, transparent look, which I personally think is super clean. Now, if you are using a photo wallpaper or a photo widget, you can tap on the widget and set the widget itself to go ahead and choose your photos or display your photos in color instead of the clear effect. Makes your photos still pop against the glass icons, which I still love. Now, going back to the customization, there's a tinted option, which is really fun. And you can use the color picker here to sample any color from your wallpaper. You can adjust the transparency just like you would on the lock screen, or use the slider to pick any different color that you'd like to. So overall, you've got 4 main styles. You have Default, you have Dark, you have Clear and Tinted, which are all built around Apple's new glass design language. That means that there's no more mismatched third-party icon packs. It is consistent, it is native, and it makes your iPhone feel so fresh and so clean. Now, if you want to steal my exact setup, I made a free iOS 26 quick start guide. It'll save you time and frustration getting everything dialed in just the way that it needs to be. Link below in the video description. Second, stop letting your screenshots die a silent death, guys. Now, most of us take a screenshot to remember something. Maybe it's an address, a phone number, something that you want to buy online, but then we end up forgetting about the screenshot until you are actually searching for something else that's completely unrelated. And then once you see that screenshot that you remembered, you forget about why you're even there. Well, maybe that's just me. With visual intelligence, those screenshots are getting a second chance at life. Now you can take a screenshot, and in that screenshot, you can tap or circle anything. It could be a product, it could be a phone number, it could be a location, even a calendar invite, and iOS will instantly identify it and give you useful options. Third-party apps like LTK, Pinterest, even Google can integrate right into the screenshots app as well. Instead of copying and pasting things and bouncing app between apps like Google, you can handle everything in one fell swoop. This works on the iPhone 15 Pro and newer because it does require Apple intelligence. Now, I have 2,435 screenshots in my app. You let me know down below how many you have. Third, stop wasting your life on hold. We've all been there, stuck listening to elevator music with no idea when someone's actually gonna pick up the phone. Maybe it's your carrier, maybe it's Comcast. Who knows? It just takes a long time. Well, with Hold Assist and iOS 26, Siri, they're gonna wait on hold for you. As soon as a real person answers, you get a notification to jump right back into the phone call. That means there are no more 20-minute time sinks waiting on hold, wasting your lunch hour. You can set the phone down, get something done, and only come back to it when it actually matters. Now, here's how you can enable it on your phone. While you are on an active call, in the bottom left-hand corner, there's gonna be a More button. Tap on that button, and then you'll see an option for Hold Assist. You'll see a live transcript of what the other party is saying. And when your phone will ring whenever the next person joins, you can tap pick up or rejoin to join the call. Fourth, let's turn your iPhone into a universal translator. Now, switching between languages usually means juggling between multiple apps, or maybe you're even copying, pasting something into Google Translate to communicate with someone who doesn't speak your native language. Well, with live translation in iOS 26, it is built right in. You can open up FaceTime, you can open up messages and start conversations, and subtitles will appear in real time. It is so great if you know someone who speaks a different language and you want to communicate with them even better. Now, here's how to enable it inside of Messages. Go and find any existing group or individual thread inside of Messages, tap on the person's name, and then once you're there, the very first pane is gonna be Info. Scroll all the way to the bottom and you're gonna see Automatically Translate. You're gonna go ahead and click on Yes, and it's gonna give you a list of languages that you can go ahead and translate to. Select your language of choice, and it's gonna tell you you wanna translate from that language to your own language. You're gonna click the back button. Here at the bottom, it'll say translating whatever that native language is. Now, the payoff here is super simple. Whether you are traveling on a work call or just chatting up with friends or family, conversations feel natural instead of being awkward, like you don't know what people are saying. This is actually part of the feature that they're rolling out for the new AirPods 2 and 3, where you can do real-time translations with those products. And fifth, you can stretch your battery without the need to sacrifice performance. Now, low power mode has always been a trade-off. You get more time with your battery, but your iPhone, it's slowed to a crawl and there's really zero fun in using it at that point because everything is so slow. Well, adaptive power mode in iOS 26, it hits differently. It makes subtle intelligent tweaks when your battery is draining faster than usual, like dimming your display or even slowing down background tasks, or even kicking on low power mode automatically when you are at 20% battery life. Now, here is how to try it. Go to settings, then go to battery, then toggle on adaptive power. If you want to, you can also turn on adaptive power notifications to get alert whenever it activates. Now, the payoff is simple. You get your iPhone, it stays fast while lasting longer. So on travel days or on long commutes, you make it through without feeling like you're stuck in slow motion. And better yet, if you still want to enable low power mode for extra battery savings, you totally can on top of adaptive power. And that is my top five features that I would set up right away in iOS 26, but that's just the day one checklist, guys, because there is so much more under the hood for you to discover. Now, if you want the full picture, get subscribed because I have more feature reviews coming your way. And you can always download my iOS 26 quick start guide to get the most out of your setup for your device. It is the first link in the video description. Now, I want to know from you, what is your favorite iOS 26 feature? Whether I talked about it, whether I didn't talk about it, maybe you found it on your own. I'd love to know what that is. Let me know down in the comments below where I'll be responding to you guys. My name is Mike, and I'm out of here.